I can't copy that nigga's thing, right? I was actually just gonna say good afternoon, but for some reason I held it. I forgot to turn off the fucking radar again. Look, I keep forgetting to turn this off. I'm really gambling with my battery here. I don't know what kind of draw this truck has, if it has, electrical leaks and stuff. Anyway, I got 30 minutes to get to the bank and deposit two checks. I got a check up here, and I got a check in my pocket, both totaling $350. And it's all going to bills. It's all going to my credit card. Can you believe it? And it's my fault. I disheveled the driveway and the walkway. You know what I realized? When the snow is really soft, you can just push it. And it does a better job than shoveling it. You just push it. All right, let's get the defroster on here. Let's get this taken care of here. So yeah, guys, good news. Good news, drum roll. I only have one hand, drum roll. How can I do a drum roll? Hold on. Drum roll. I got the job at AutoZone. Bum, bum, bum. Got the job. Look at this. It takes a USB plug. Look, a USB thing goes in there. You know, that's the same size as a USB for the printer. That's a, you know, that's like a printer USB plug. So I got the job, $10 an hour, instead of, he said a lot of people get hired at like $9.25, but he likes me, $10. I'm not going to complain, all right? The deli was $11, this is $10, and I'll be more into this, so to be a little happier, I'll sacrifice $1 an hour. That's $40, and he's starting me with part-time. He said everyone starts part-time to see how you work, but I'm going right up to full-time. I guarantee it, all right? I'll show them why I'm full-time, all right? I'm aiming for a fucking parts manager and then store manager. That's my goal. That's what I'm doing. So, $10 an hour, part-time, no big deal. That's actually good for me right now with the community service. I can bang out the community service while I'm doing part-time. And then when I bang out those 50 hours, when I go full time, I don't have to worry about anything else but work. I gotta go to this like class, another like orientation. It's 4 to 8 hours, but it's paid. And they just go over like how to change a starter, you know, stuff that, you know, I actually could learn how to do that. I don't know how to do a starter. I only know how to do oil changes, change batteries, air filters, windshield wiper fluid, you know, stuff like that. I don't know how to do coolant flushes. I don't know how to check starters, you know, adjust distributor caps and rotors. So this stuff I can learn. I know how to rotate tires, change a spare tire. I don't know how to change brakes. I know what makes up a brake system. I just never had the tools to get the piston caliper or piston off or whatever to get the brake pads out, stuff like that. But I'll learn. I'm real into this. I'm really into this job, so I'll learn. I got 25 minutes. Luckily, it didn't snow that bad to snow in my truck to where I can't get out. I should be able to drive right over this. Yup. Well, today's Monday. Oh, look, I got no traction. Look at this. Today's Monday, which is a full rack of ribs at Miller's for $11.99. So I'm contemplating maybe going to treat myself to a nice dinner tonight. But they got all the kids fucking shoveling and shit over here. I mean, I don't plan to ever own a house in New York. But if I ever fucking hit the lotto and I did buy a house up here and become a snowbird. People that don't know what snow, I know a lot of people hear that term snowbird, but they really don't really know. A lot of people don't, you know, younger people, young kids, they don't know what snowbird means. What, a bird that likes the snow? No. A snowbird is a person that lives in the north, like Canada, New York, Maine, New Jersey, for the warm months. And then for the cold months, they go down to the house that they own in, like, Florida. That's a snowbird. People that own a house in a warm area, and they go to that house in the winter. Snowbird. If I ever come into a lot of money, I plan to be a snowbird. Because a lot of people tell me they can see me as a snowbird. And I can see myself as a snowbird, too. A lot of people go down, like, if they're a snowbird, they go down and, like, you know, like, September, oh God, look at this, I'm fucking spinning out, I got no traction whatsoever. They go down, look at this, I can't even go, look, I'm not even doing 20 miles an hour, I can't. God, these tires suck. I gotta get some sandbags and really do what that guy said. And the problem is too, like I said, it's rear wheel drive, but only one side. Only one side gets the power from the drivetrain or whatever, it's retarded. I never heard of a truck or a car that only has, you know, this would be a... Too bad this really doesn't have four-wheel drive. It really is a shame. Really is a shame. But yeah, I would be a snowbird. I would be a snowbird. But I wouldn't go down early like that. I would stay up here till about like November. As long as it wasn't snowing and it wasn't like in the 30s, I would stay up. And then go down from like November to, you know, April. That's what I would do. I started to say if I ever own a house in New York, I would own a snowblower. That's what I wanted to say. If I ever had my own place, I would get a snowblower. I would get a snowblower. I mean, seriously, if you don't have a snowblower in 2016, I don't know why you don't. It's pretty, you know, they're pretty affordable. $400 for the one at Home Depot is a nice snowblower. Why can't you afford that? Open a Home Depot credit card. It's no interest for 18 months. $400. 18 months. You could pay fucking $20 a month. No interest on the balance and pay that off easily. I mean, I don't know if your minimum would be only $20. It would probably be between $25 and $35, but still. You could get away with the minimum payment with no interest. That's the best thing about new, you know, when you open a credit card, no interest for 18 months, 12 or 18 months. That's when you balance transfer. That's when you do your balance transfer. I'm not gonna make this light. Oh shit, I'm sliding. Fuck. Now I gotta stay at the fucking light. I was sliding. I got 20 minutes to get to the bank. Go into this gas station. There's nobody on the fucking road. Nobody on the fucking road. God, these tires really suck, guys. I have to... You should see how I'm accelerating right now just to fucking... Just to get the truck to go somewhere. But I knew these tires were shot when I fucking bought the truck. That was no surprise. With it being only rear one-wheel drive, that doesn't help either. If I had power going to both wheels, it would be a big help. I think that's why the previous owner said about sandbags. He bought like 4 to 6 sandbags and put it in the bed of the truck to weigh down the back. I'm pretty sure that's why he did it. Alright, but winter's almost over already this fucking year. It's already... It's almost fucking 2 weeks into February, so I'm not gonna worry about buying that right now, sandbags. And by next winter, I'll probably have new tires on here. Nice tires, all season tires, winter tires. tops, no tires. I used to get tires like a Jeep has with those big fucking tread, those big squares. That's probably what I need on here. Probably have a random test coming any minute. Any minute, random test. I might go to Walmart after this just to see if they have that fucking red shirt that I need. Let me go down the oil section like I said I would, since I'm already out, the truck's warmed up. Really wasn't that bad. The snowfall wasn't that much to when by the time the plow came down my street, because all the snow wasn't pushed against the side of my truck like it was last time. All right, that fucking, these boots don't, the water goes right through these fucking boots, the snow. I thought these boots were like completely sealed. They're not. They're not. The other day I was coming home and I was trying to get home and turn off the engine before it gave me a random test. And right when I fucking turned the key, it went off. And once it goes off, you can't stop it. Like, turning off the truck won't stop it. You have to blow into it. There's no way around it. But I just couldn't believe it. That split second I turned the key, it went off. That split second. God, good thing I didn't go to that super Walmart last night. I didn't have the gas to do that. We made it to the fucking bank. I gotta get this check in. I gotta get these checks in. TD is actually really good with their hours. Oh god, this parking lot. Right, just left the bank. Now I am on my low fuel, of course. Low fuel. Well, now that I know I have the job for sure, I'm gonna go to Walmart and see how much a fucking red collar shirt is in my size. They don't give shirts. I should have said something to the district manager when he called me. He asked me if I had any questions about the dress code. I should have said yeah. Actually, I said I should have been like, I'm just curious why the company doesn't provide shirts. Then I would have said, you know, it's not a big deal. I'll go pick one up. But I just, you know, I never heard of you know, having to provide your own shirt to work. So, no big deal. I also need black shoes. I really don't want to wear my Nikes, because, you know, I just don't want to. I didn't even think he said no name brand shoes. I think he said they have to be plain black shoes. So, even if I wear them the first day, I could just be like, yeah, I went to Walmart and they didn't have any. I gotta go to the other location today. I'm just wearing these for today. But I don't know why that would be a big deal. You know, why would wearing Nikes be a big deal? They're just shoes. The customer's not looking down at your feet. You know? Is what it is. what it is. I'm just happy to have it. Doing a background check and a license check. They're going to see my DWI on there. And if they ask me about it, I'll just say, yeah, that's actually was a mistake. And I'm fighting it right now. I'm actually winning the case. It's going to be taken off. Gotta watch them come back and say, oh, DB convicted of a misdemeanor, whatever the fuck, whatever that is. I don't see why that would affect my job. I'm working inside customer service. But, not gonna affect my fucking job. Should have probably told him that at the interview. I probably should have just told him about it, but should have just said, yeah, I got a dick cop who gave me a DWI, but I'm fighting it and I'm winning the case, but whatever. Then if he says, why didn't I tell him about it? I could always say, well, you know, I'm winning the case, it's coming off. I didn't really think it was gonna be a problem at the time of employment, you know, because it's not going to be there. So, see what happens. Not a big deal. Say, like, as a manager, though, if he gets a speeding ticket, he could lose his job because he can't do what his job description, which I thought that was a little stupid. Everyone gets speeding tickets, you know. It's sometimes you got a dick cop. It happens. Station lady never called me back. I should really call her. Just for fun. Say, you know, I called you last Monday. You told me you were going to call me back the next day, Tuesday. And now tomorrow, 7 days since you told me you were going to call me back. Then I'll call her boss and say, you know, she's not really that good of a hiring manager. You got someone who's calling, who's interested in the job, calling to find out an update, and you got this a manager who's blowing off the potential employee that could, you know, that can run circles around her. God, this parking lot's terrible right now. Look at this. I guess it goes slipping and sliding in here. Let me get some speed here. Yeah. Watch, e-brake. I don't have enough speed. Guy wants to cross. Come on. Here you go, buddy. No problem. God, I'm slushing around everywhere. Jesus.
don't know if I should park right next to this truck. Let me go over there. My mother always taught me, go where no one can park on one side of you. You see how this is a wagon thing over here? So that means nobody can park on my right. That means someone can only park on my left. Alright, so we're here. Going into Walmart now. We'll see ya inside. Right. Just left Walmart, but don't worry, I'm going back. I had to buy a different pair of pants than the ones I have, because the ones I bought when I was driving for my uncle's limo company are too big, too baggy, you know, they don't look professional. So, gonna put the tag on that one and come back and return them. Right? Because, you know, I need all the money I can get right now. I'm in a fucking jam. I put the tag on. Hopefully, you know, they don't usually question anything. So they bought the wrong size. And if he tries to say, oh, these aren't the right ones, I'm gonna say, I just bought them. And I literally just bought them. They're like $11, $13 with tax, but still. I got a shirt. It's not red like a stop sign red. But it's red. It's the best I can do right now, unless you want to buy me shirts. I'll say that's what happens when the company doesn't provide employees with shirts. The employees get the wrong color, wrong shade of red. What are you fucking doing, dude? Come on. Jesus fucking Christ. People don't know what they're doing. See what I'm talking about? Fucking don't know where they want to go. I live real close to Walmart. Look at this guy. Wasn't up further enough to get the arrow. This stupid fuck. Stupid fuck. I just don't understand it. I just don't understand. Where's the common sense of these people? They've only been driving fucking how many years? How many years you've been driving? I don't get it. I just don't fucking get the common sense. Where the fuck is it? Fucking moron. Fucking moron. Taking 10 years to make the turn. Make the turn! I just don't get it. I just don't get it. If you're making the turn, make the fucking turn. Look, I just did it real easy. Snowblower. I don't get certain people. I just don't get them. Ooh, we're sliding. Alright guys, I'm on my way back to Walmart. I'm a little nervous. Not nervous, but I'm a little nervous. Because the old pair of pants have a lot of lint on it. You know, and a brand new pair is not going to have any lint.
So I could say my mother was in here like an hour ago or so. I apologize for the hair and stuff. I have four dogs. There's hair floating around everywhere. I already took the tag. The tag ripped on me when I was pulling it off, so I'm just gonna say, well, the tag says 38, but the actual pants say 40. So I'm gonna say that the tag was wrong, so my mom bought them the wrong pair. I wanna return these so I can go get the right pair, the right size. I'm also gonna say that she was supposed to get the elastic kind, and these aren't the elastic kind. Just in case he said, like, oh shit, just in case he said, go get him and we'll exchange him right up here. I don't want them to do that because I'm not trying to exchange, I'm trying to get a refund. So, Walmart's usually pretty good with taking stuff back. You know, they don't really question anything. So, we're gonna go see what happens. Then we'll go check out the oils and stuff. Only thing now is I need black shoes, so I'll go check those out too, but I'm not buying those right now. Plain black shoes. Kind of reminds me when I started working at McDonald's when I was 16. I needed non-slip black shoes. Alright, we're turning yellow here. We're about to start going here. Look how dark it is already. Hey, 5:45 and it's dark instead of 4:30, so it's starting to stay out lighter longer, thank God. I gotta go make it. I should have made that cash deposit when I was fucking there earlier. What a moron. My uncle used my Shell card last night for gas and stuff. Gave me the $30, but I wanna pay the bill with his $30. That will count as my payment for the month. And this way I can leave my 20 bucks on gas sitting on there for a month. So 20% on 20 is, I don't even fucking know. 20% of 100 is 20. So it's like a few bucks. Here we are back at Walmart. So Home Depot, their drug test facility people called me today to give me my results. They wanted my social security number to pull it up. Which I don't really want it to, I don't really want to have to give them my whole social security over the phone. I can see the last four. You know, I don't know why they need the whole thing. To me, that's kind of, you know, I don't like that. Even though I've done it before over the phone, I'm not too concerned really what the test results are now that I have AutoZone as a job. Did the return, no problem. No questions asked. 1, 2, 3. Right, guys, we are down the Walmart aisle and we have tons of different oils here. Tons of different oils. All right, so we're gonna talk about what we talked about. All right, the only car oil you can use in your motorcycle, because there's a lot of debate about that. There's only one type of car oil that's okay to use in your bike, and that's the Rotella T6. I wouldn't do it personally, but I know a lot of people who have. It's not the 5W40, it would be the 10W40 Rotella T6, which I don't see here. But that's the only one that you would be able to use in your bike. I would still use the Mobil 1 4T.
which Walmart does not carry motorcycle oil, specific motorcycle oil. They do not carry. Some do, don't get me wrong. Some states do. But Florida and New York, I know for a fact, do not have motorcycle oil inside Walmart. Okay? I bet you $100 if I went and looked at every single one of these oils, none of them would be four-cycle, four-stroke oil. Alright? Okay, so what we spoke about is right here. This is what I wanted. This is what I wanted to use in my truck right here. The Mobil Super High Mileage Regular Motor Oil 5W30. This is not synthetic. This is regular, conventional, high mileage motor oil. This is $447 a quart. What I plan to use now is the Pennzoil High Mileage 5W30, which I do not see here. Here it is. 5W30, okay? This is what I'm gonna continue to use in my truck. All right, it's the same price, $447 a quart. So I actually, you know, can make a choice. You know, I really could try the Mobil, you know, just to see how it performs, and then decide if I want to stay between the Mobil and the Pennzoil. But I'm really not sure which route I'm going to go, and I have a little bit of time to decide that. I think I might try the Mobil. You know, it's only for 3,000 miles. We'll see how it runs with the Mobil in there. You know, and if not, I'll stay with the Pennzoil. I'm not going to try to switch back and forth 100 times, but I'm going to switch once and give it a shot. Alright. You have a lot of different Mobil ones. But these are all car oils. Okay? Car oils. Alright. Super Tech. Never really heard of it. I wouldn't personally use it, but there's people that do.
Any Carolina?
Here's your regular Pennzoil conventional. Not high mileage, not synthetic, just regular conventional Pennzoil. 5W30, this is what I would need for my truck. Okay, and next to it, you have your Valvoline. Okay, again guys, you're looking for these seals on it. These like certified things, SM, those are like certifications. Okay, over here, you have your Castrol GTX conventional regular oil 5W30. Someone said online that Castrol is one of the worst oils. They're an idiot. Castrol GTX is really good stuff. I don't know what the guy's smoking. All right, up here you have your GTX high mileage, but this is a synthetic blend. I don't want synthetic blend in my car, in my truck. All right, it's a very old truck, so we're not gonna use synthetic blend. Down here we have your Quaker State. I've never used it before. Quaker State. We got your Royal Purple. This stuff is expensive, but a lot of people say Royal Purple is really good stuff. Here's the 5W30. Synthetic. This is synthetic. I don't want synthetic. All right, and then down over here you have your, you know, your big ones. So I would go with this one right here. High mileage 5W30. 5 gallons. I only need 4.5. 5 quarts. I mean, I only need 4.5 quarts, and $17.47. All right. So if I was to spend $450, right? So let's say it was $4. 4 times 5 is 20, plus the 50 cents 4 times, that's $22 or something like that, right? Plus tax. So see how you're saving a little money by buying the bigger one? In most cars, you need 4 to 4.5 to 5 quarts. So it just makes sense to get the big one. But this is the one I would get right here if I was staying. No, sorry. 5W30. This is the one I would need right here if I was staying with Pennzoil. All right, if I was gonna give the Mobil a shot, the Mobil high mileage, it would be right here, 1517. Here's the Mobil super high mileage right here. Okay, this is it right here. So I would either get this one, or I would get this one. All right, those are the two. Those are my two choices. Then you got your regular conventional Pennzoil. You got your Valvoline. All right, here's the Valvoline high mileage, full synthetic. I don't want full synthetic. See, Valvoline doesn't have a conventional high mileage. All right. What's over here? Same shit. Guys, this is where you can come and get your OBDII reader, but this one's expensive. I wouldn't get it here. Yeah, guys. Then you also have your gear lubricant. I don't see it. Where's the trans? Oh, here it is, down over here. Your transmission fluid oil. Gear lubricant, I guess that's what it's considered. Two cycle engine oil. It's for like a lawnmower, a weed whacker. Oh, here's the transmission fluid, AFT4 transmission fluid. But I've seen the one that looks like this, but it has better stuff. That's really it, guys. I mean, they're all the same, just different brands. But personally, if you need conventional oil, regular conventional, not even high mileage, I would either go with the Mobil or the Pennzoil or the Castrol GTX. That's what I would go with. All right, here's the GT. This is synthetic one though, you see? So see, I'm not using synthetic, but you might in your car. Most new cars use synthetic, so you would be looking at synthetic blends. Just don't get synthetic blend, get full synthetic. You want something that says full synthetic, if you need synthetic. Like my mother's Mazda 3, 2012 Mazda 3, she used full synthetic, all right? So they put Pennzoil full synthetic in. Let's find the Pennzoil full synthetic. Let's find the Pennzoil full synthetic. I don't even see it in the big bottle, so let's see if we can find it in the smaller bottle. Here it is. I don't know if it was 5W30, but here's the synthetic Pennzoil right here, synthetic blend. No, this is synthetic blend. I need full synthetic. Synthetic blend. Oh, I'm fucking looking right at it. I did 2 seconds ago. Here it is. I didn't see it because it's not yellow. Full synthetic Pennzoil. 10W30, 5W20, and then you know you got your different things. So that's what she would get in her car. But I like the Mobil. If you needed regular oil. Does Mobil even make regular Mobil oil? Oh, this is all synthetic now. The Mobil one doesn't make regular oil. See, like right here, guys, like Motorcraft, like brands you never heard of, I wouldn't go with. Like D-Lo, what the hell is D-Lo? Never heard of it. Don't get it. I wouldn't. All right, I wouldn't. Advanced full synthetic, synthetic. All this is synthetic. I thought Mobil made regular oil, and it's synthetic. Like, you know, this is like a Walmart brand. Super Duty. Anyway, guys, let's look at oil filters. These are air filters. These are your oil filters right here. Okay, as you see, what is the most that you see here? Fram. Fram. Crap. This is all crap, and I'm gonna show you why. I'll show you why these are crap. Oh, that one I can't show you. Let me find a regular Fram. Regular Fram oil filter here. Here. This is why Fram sucks. Look at this. Look at this. It's just all cardboard. It's cardboard. That's why it sucks. Alright, I'm telling you, Fram sucks. Alright? Purgulator sucks. Bosch is alright. You can go with a Bosch. You see how it's enclosed in like a metal? That's what you want. Alright, a nice fucking filter. Bosch. But what you really want is down here. KNN. This is what you want. KNN. KNN. That's what you want. Do they have the one I used for my motorcycle? KNN. Looking for KNN 303. 303, I don't see it, because these are mostly, they mostly cater to cars, alright? But this is why you want a K&N. Alright, let me look at a better one. Performance Gold. I'm probably going to need one that's big like this, okay? Okay, this is why you go with K&N. Look at that. Look what it's enclosed in. Look at this nice thing here. This is nice. This is quality. With a nice wrench off, nice seal on the bottom. This is why you want K&N, right? This is just a better filter. I mean, come on. I don't have to explain it. It's just a better filter. Okay, $14, all right? These are good filters. $12.58. The smaller ones are a little cheaper, all right? But trust me. So much better. You come over here, you look at your fucking Frams. Okay? 377. 377. Right? The prices are, you know, kind of the same in a way. But trust me, Fram sucks. You want to at least go with a Bosch. Okay? If you don't want to get the K&N, which I'm telling you, get the K&N, go with the Bosch. Go with the Bosch, I'm telling you. Okay? Now here are the motorcycle ones. Fram motorcycle. Fram. I would never, ever. Never. I would never do it. Get yourself a nice drain thing over here. Nice drain pan. Get yourself a nice long funnel if you need it. See, I need one like this because of the location of my, of where I fill mine. But I'm telling you, look, here's the magazine to know what filter that you need. Is this all Fram though? Oh, this shows all of them. I need HP 2001. Is that what it said? HP? Hold on a minute, 99. S10. Where was it? S10, here it is. HP or PS. HP PS. HP PS. HP or PS. HP 2001 or PS. HP or PS. Okay. HP 2001 or PS 2001. Depends. This is the performance, or I can get the Pro Series. HP 2001 or PS 2001. PS 2001. I don't see it. I don't have any. I don't have any. Alright, well, this is the one. That's the one. I can remember that. That's easy to remember. Now I know what kind of K&N oil filter I definitely need for my truck. 2001 HPPS. 2001. Lovely, I just need seafoam. Gum out, multi-system tune-up. Seafoam is good. You put this in your gas tank when you get gas. Just clean it out real nice for you. You can also do this one. Seafoam's on fucking sale too. $674. Jesus. Should really pick one up. There's so many different ones though, you know, guys. There's so many different ones. You got fuel injector cleaner, gum out. Fuel injector carburetor cleaner. Fuel injector cleaner. High mileage fuel injector cleaner. I should pick. Look at this. High mileage full system cleaner. High mileage full system cleaner. What's the difference between... Oh, this one's not a high mileage. This one's a high mileage. So I get a high mileage fuel injector cleaner. Or I get a high mileage fuel system cleaner. Does this do fuel injectors too? Direct in the fuel injector, intake valve, combustion chamber. Combustion chamber, that's what I need. I got low compression. What about this one? Yeah, this one's a combustion chamber, fuel injector, intake valve. I'm just going to go with this one. I'm going to go with this one, 284. I'm going to go with this one. I'm going to go with this. Get one of these. You know? What else do I need? WD-40, engine cleaner. Parts cleaner, white grease, lubricant. See, this is what I need too, lubricant for belts, stop squeaks, super tech. But last time I got, which one did I get last time? I didn't get that one. I got this one, Prestone belt dressing. But I should maybe try this one. Should maybe try that one. But, you know, who cares really? Alright guys, let's get the fuck out of here. All your cleaners and shit. All your cleaners. Guys, whenever you get tire shine, don't get foam. Don't get a foam. Get like this. This is good right here. This stuff's really good right here. This stuff's good right here. Great shit right here. I'm telling you, don't get a foam. Whatever you do, no foam, because the foam gets dry really quick. The stuff that stays on wet stays wet. Here's the fuel pump, guys, that I have. Oh, they don't have any more. They don't have any more. Look, I need a jack. Is this where the jacks are? Air compressor. I always wanted to get one of those too, an air compressor. I don't see a jack. Oh, here's the jack. Really? Only $18? Oh, it's a 2-ton. See, I need more than that. I need more than a 2-ton. I need a 3-ton. $80, that's more fucking like it. See what I mean? Unfucking believable. Unbelievable. Security camera's in use. Look, it's recording me. Look. Hey. Hey. Alright guys, let's get the fuck out of here.
I just went to McDonald's to get my 2 for 2. And they raised the price on the 2 for 2 already. It's not $2 for $2 anymore. It's $2 for $2.50. Can you believe it? Already. That's New York for you. Always, I don't know if it's the whole state of New York. Or always raising the price. Just stick with a fucking special already. You got a special for the people. Stick with it. Fucking not even 2 weeks and you're upping the price already. Ridiculous. That's ridiculous. Giving someone a deal, let him keep the deal for once. Do something. Keep it. Jesus. Anyway, guys, that's it for tonight. Hope you have a good night. Happy birthday to Stan. We'll see you soon. Peace.